Welcome back everyone. In this lecture, we're gonna learn about color, the most important factor in graphic design and also scientific design illustration. So we will learn how we can use color and especially use the color wheel in our design to make a better scientific illustration. So first, to learn the basic about color, just go to YouTube and search color graphic design. So this is a very nice explained video about the basic about color and how to work with color. So just pause this video right now and then go to YouTube and watch this video. Welcome back. I hope you guys already watched this video. And to apply the color wheel, normally I go to paletton.com. So this is a website you can create the color palette and also very easy to use and it's completely free. So first thing, you can see this is monochromatic. So it means like it's just one color with the different shades. So normally I will apply these when I create a heat map where the lighter color show the lesser degree and the darker color show the more intense. So you can add the complementary color here. So you can see that the two colors from the opposite side of the color wheel will always create a contrast. Move these up here, you can create different shades. So blue and orange, red and green, and yellow and purple always contrast. So normally I will use the contrast color when I create a graph comparing the two different factor or treatment. So at adjacent color is the three colors that stay next to each other. So you can either choose the cold color or the warmer color over here. So you can also add complementary color. And now you have three warm color and one cold color. So move these away from each other to create more contrast or closer to each other to create more harmony color. So if you can set this as main color, it will move it to the colder and then just only one warmer color. So just play around with this color wheel. And also up here is each point is the shades you see in the square. So you can make it like more contrast or more closer to each other. However, in Microsoft PowerPoint, we just need to choose the main color and the PowerPoint software will automatically create a different shades of that main color for us. So always just choose the main color that you like. And then when you go to PowerPoint, go to View and then Slide Master. So from here, you can customize your color. Click in the main and click Color and Customize Color. Or you can choose in this color over here, but I always like to customize it. Okay, so from here you can choose any color and then choose the eyedropper tool and drop it to the color that you like over here. And like so, you can change all of the color to create your custom color palette. So I recommend to do this before you start to design because you want to have the consistent color palette throughout all of your design. So when you save it, you will have it here and close master. And now every color, every shapes or a letter will have your custom color built in when you choose to change the color. However, if you're not confident with color or you just want to find inspiration from the internet, just go to internet and search color palette. So they'll have tons of example and you can just go to image and choose all of the color palette that you like and just eyedropper or like steal the color. It's not even stealing, but it's like inspired from the color from the internet. So same thing, just go to View, Slide Master, Color, and Customize Color. And step by step, you can customize all of your color by taking the inspiration from the internet. So in this next section, I'm gonna give some of the practical example of how you can apply the color palette in your design. So in this first example, I have three circles with three different contrasting color, but it doesn't look great. So why is that? Because the color shade is like too dark, and one way to fix this is change it to the lighter shades of that same color. For example, I choose lighter green, lighter red, and lighter blue. So you have something like a pastel color, and immediately it look more pleasant, more harmonized, and more professional. So one of the quick way when you see the color is too contrast is to tone it down, to choose the lighter shade of that same color. Or I just can simply go to the internet to find inspiration of the color combination. Next, I will show you how we can apply this color theory in communicating our scientific data. So first, I will go to insert column. So I will create a chart column over here, and I will just choose the default data. So for this example, I want to create a two contrasting set of data. So I will delete the third series over here. So you can see that by default, Microsoft choose the two contrasting color here. Very nice. So you can go to color and choose different color palette or monochromatic. But here, I want to make the contrast, so monochromatic will not work for this example. So you can see that you can go to change the color by choosing the two color from the opposite side of the color wheel. So here, I can have blue and red or green and red. So if I choose green for one data, so opposite green is like red, purplish. So I will go back to my color field and I will choose red. You can see that it creates a nice contrasting effect. If I change it to a blue, the color that next to the green and it doesn't create that contrasting effect because both of them are cold color. And if I just simply change it to the warmer color over here, so you can see that green and orange will create a nice contrasting effect. So this is one trick you can do if you want to compare the two data. So in the next example, I will make another chart. So I go to insert chart. For example, I want to make a pie chart. So close this to choose default. So you can see that for this example, I want to focus in the largest portion and the rest will not be in the greater interest. So I can separate it out like this and choose the monochromatic and just change this main thing I want to focus on. So for example, I want to talk about the high rate or high percentage of some factor. You can see that I can create a contrasting color with the blue one, like red or orange, the warmer shades of color. So after I try a few color, I see that red will work the best to create a contrasting effect. And these three series over here is not that. I don't want to focus on that, so I choose the monochromatic for them. So you can see that this is a combination of monochromatic and contrasting color. And you can use this to create an instant visual effect of contrasting in your data. Here's another example of using contrasting color in your graph. So here I have orange and blue in one graph and green and red in the next graph. So these are all opposite color from the opposite side of the color wheel. And also I choose different type of graph. So one is column style and one is the line style with the marker. And also this graph have two axes and it's got color coded so you can know which axis to read what data. So thank you very much for listening guys. I hope you learned something about the color contrast and the color harmonize. So see you in the next lecture.